approaching the match and kind of some tips and tricks on that. And then we will walk through the human side and kind of give you a glimpse into how you're supposed to be surviving the invasion.
Mm-hmm.
And then in the very end, we will just play. Like, this has been something that we have been having an absolute blast playing internally. Just
the play
because of
a ton of
fun. I mean, it's just one of those things where there's just so many things that have come together to make every match unique and different and interesting and fun. And just having that all coded in this vibrant, enjoyable, like, fun, terrifying, like, it's just
all the above. Literally all the above. Hey, well, watch where you're swinging.
Get out of my way. Okay, so clowns.
Yeah. So we started off. You mentioned the 15-minute timer.
Yep.
And we have the cotton candy cocoons kind of all around. Is that what you wanted to start off? You know what?
I'm gonna say, like, as a clown, you're getting into the match. Like, the humans are there, obviously, but they're gonna be sneaking around and stuff. So you'll notice that there are there's cocoons left over from, you know, the earlier portion of the invasion. Let's see if we can track one down. Oh, you got one.
Right here.
Sweet. So yeah, there are stray cocoons scattered around that exist. They're randomly placed in different spots. They're just kind of all over the place. And as a clown, it's definitely a very beneficial thing to go and find those early to begin hooking them up to what you see here, which is a lackey generator.
Mm-hmm.
There's four lackey generators on the map, and each lackey generator has four slots, so there's 16 total. What this does as you're hooking these up is it begins to spawn lackey helpers, little NPCs that will pop out here in probably about 15 seconds if I'm looking at that timer right. And they patrol the map. They begin looking out, and the amount of lackeys that are spawning at each generator are dependent on how many cocoons you have hooked up. So as we fill a lackey generator up, it spawns up to four of them. Oh,
here's one.
Hey, buddy.
Little homie.
So he's going to go out and start looking. So yeah, the four generators on the map, they're positioned randomly again, like a big thing about this game. Like, we wanted to keep randomization to gameplay elements of that high level to make sure that these things play out differently each time. So there you have four of them, and you're going to want to disperse the cocoons and team up to try and make sure that each one is getting filled up, because you want that map coverage. The lackeys do begin to give you that opportunity, and as you'll watch the match unfold, it begins to show how effective they are at, like, actually spotting, like, attaching to humans. They jump on humans. They sound alarms when they can't get to them, like if they're in hiding spots and whatnot. So they give you a leg up. So it's very important to focus early game on getting those cocoons hooked up. And kind of one like final thing I can say about the lackey generators is that if you hook them all up, there's 16 slots, you actually trigger, oh, hello there.
Speaking of which, let's get a second cocoon in.
Let's just get this cocoon so I can hook it up and show off what's... I've got this one, Albert. Oh, wait, okay. You're sharing the screen, so... but what you'll see that pops up on Albert's right-hand side of the screen is a tracker of how many cocoons there are, because once you do reach... Well, sorry.
That's Aaron, a dead cocoon.
Yeah, Aaron is not dead yet, so one thing I'll call out here is when humans are cocooned, they will have a suffocation timer, and... How long you stay alive is obviously how long you have before you're dead, or how long you have left to breathe before you die. So once he finally dies, then it's considered hooked up, and then that's an upgrade to the lackey generator.
But until then, he is very much alive in there. He's got a limited supply of oxygen, and... Oh, it looks like Jordan... We lost your cam. One second. Oh, no. I think you're back. Okay, cool. But yeah, someone can save him, or if the human happened to have looted, like, a sharp object, like a knife or something, they can actually cut themselves out. But other humans are actually able to hop on over and rescue him, even if the cocoon's just on the ground. It doesn't necessarily have to be on the hook.
Yeah, it doesn't. It doesn't have to be on the hook, but yeah, anytime that someone has a sharp object. So yeah, there's a lot of fun there, so it comes down to kind of, like, gauging out your approach to it, and then clowns need to keep moving, so if they're gonna head out, and there's a good chance that, you know... Oh, look at that. See, someone came over and they're trying to get him out.
Yeah. No, Albert. We gotta stop them from doing this.
I don't think so. Get out of here. Okay.
Wow. Okay. Downed immediately. We show off the clontality now?
We're not supposed to be playing now.
You know what? Why not?
No, don't. Oh, well, okay. I guess whoever that was deserved it then.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. They deserved it. Goodbye.
All
All right, I'm gonna try something, Jordan, and hopefully your camera's self-freezing. I don't know.
Okay. I'm gonna keep going.
Yeah, for
just,
sure.
Just as long as my audio is still good, I think that's what matters more than anything. That's still cool.
Agreed.
Cool. So let's see. Yeah, covered. So the early clown apocalypse. So if you hook up all the generators on the map as a clown team, you trigger the early clown apocalypse. So instead of having to wait for 15 minutes, mm-hmm. it happens whenever you finalize it. It has the countdown still, and humans have like a minute to get out of the map at that. So it's definitely a power play, especially if you're feeling like they're very sneaky and difficult to track down. Sometimes it's worth it to turn and focus on filling up those generators. So because it also, once again, provides that lackey map control.
Yeah. Let's find some more coons or find some humans. When you're looking for humans, you want to look out for these white circular noise pings around. White or red. Red is normally like a lackey's caught them or they're trying to escape. I don't know what that was. What was that, like a baseball?
Probably.
Oh, we got Miles coming in hot. Oh, the clown jump. Good cutoff.
Okay.
The ray gun is more for harvesting purposes. Actually, when a human is down, they can actually we can cocoon them even faster. And as you saw there,
yes.
We got a little boosted stat. If the clowns work together to cotton candy someone, that makes it even faster. You guys saw Jordan do a little bit of a clown jump there. That's a way of clowns to travel around the map. There's a bit of a fog of war. You throwing the cocoon at them?
I am. That's my tactic, man. He's gonna shoot us. I feel like we're losing.
Go for it.
No, I didn't have anything constructive right there.
All right, hit him with it. Cocoon him up. And as you can see from battle, we've taken a little bit of damage. One of our abilities is the LOL ability, and that gives us the joy of laughter. Laughter is, of course, the best medicine, so it gives you a little bit of a damage buff, speed boost, and healing over time. And yeah, you can kind of yeet these things. Who's in here?
So honestly, you know, let's play catch.
Play catch with whoever's in. All right, one more.
Okay, I'll come up. Sorry. Discovering humans is very much a noise-based thing. So when we are kind of going over the specifics in the human side, we can kind of explain the different things that generate noise. Mm-hmm. But on the clown side, visually, you are tracking those little right white dots. And then you also get, I think you got that too, Albert, we get pings as well when humans mess up at the minigame QTs or are jumped by a lackey or are alarmed by a lackey.
Someone's failing a skill check over here by the carousel.
Yeah, you're getting those notifications. They're brief, so you got to kind of keep an eye on them, but they do give you the opportunity, if the humans mess up, to kind of track them down and actually jump into...
Oh, someone's trying to get out the portal machine here.
Oh, wow. Ooh. How did you not block him?
What do you mean block him? I got air horn, dude. Oh, my good booty.
Okay, so a big thing about the map is for clowns to actually succeed is keeping track of the escape objective. So like I was talking about these earlier, it's extremely crucial to have map control as the clown, just understanding where things are. We went to great lengths to get all of the gameplay objectives and items and things randomizing constantly. So every match you're jumping into, on the match, they're in different spots, different configurations, like different placements, so that it's never the exact same layout each time. So it's really important to move around the map and find where things are. And as you can see, we're able to cotton candy the objectives to give that extra interaction where humans are coming up and clearing cotton candy, and they have the QTs pop, so they have that risk of making more noise. So it's definitely a control thing, and you want to be able to kind of move through and keep that stuff under control and covered, and just knowing where it's at is very valuable too,
right,
for when the time comes. So.
And speaking of coverage, we've killed a fair few a bit of humans, but I think the chat, you know, there's definitely going to be some eagle-eyed people in there. Big pop-up saying dead humans have been revived. I know this has been a question I've seen a couple times, you know, just on socials and Discord, but. Yeah, clowns, when you get downed, clowns can be downed with weapons, They can only be killed with a sharp object, or say like a firearm, if humans are lucky enough to get one. Humans, however, once they're dead, they've only got a one-time respawn resurrection machine that's located somewhere on the map. And that, you know, is that speaking of which, I don't think we kept track of that, and the humans are back. Although they've only got about 3.5 minutes to find a good escape for them.
Yep. So we're still advantaged here, even though we're not like actually playing right now. But this will all come into play. Where are we at right now? Let me make sure we're kind of covering. You'd already hit on the clown talities a little bit, but the secondary weapons. So like you get the choice of having one of the cotton candy ray guns, which is used for cotton candy cocooning people, and then you have a secondary weapon, which is usually around killing. There's some that are a little bit have some different things tied to them, but for the most part, it's about getting the humans down onto the ground to cotton candy easier, or you can just keep wailing on them and die. So that's definitely not worth as much because clowns are very much about getting the cocoons and really bolstering their food supply. So that's that's an important part of really kind of succeeding in this. So talked about our main abilities. Did you show off jump a little bit?
I showed off jump. I talked about LOL. They just saw me use the balloon dog for a little bit of tracking action. Okay. Although the second I tracked them, I realized that they were on the boat. And then they left. So what's your ability that you've got on?
So I've got the finger lure, or it's a hypnotic lure. It's basically Jumbo's ability where he's able to lure the humans towards him and give them a whack. So it's definitely...
Let's go find a human to test it on.
Yeah, I'm going around.
So we got 2 minutes till the clown apocalypse. We're doing more of a clown tutorial, but I still would like to not let a couple of these humans escape.
I don't think that's gonna happen. We'll see, though. Use your balloon dog. What are you doing? You're the one
it's
that's
on
supposed to be helping
3
us.
Seconds, bro.
Oh, my goodness.
Okay, here we go.
Okay, come on, buddy. Show us the way.
Oh, we were right over here. Jordan,
where?
Around the corner.
Oh,
cut him off.
Yep. Miles, this way.
Oh, he's running out towards the
over
carousel.
Here. No, they come back this way, Albert.
Wait, what?
We found two more.
Oh, there's another?
Yeah. There was a couple of them over here, so I went this way. Okay, there's one. Just have to get into position.
Yep. And so we're at a minute left at the 30-second mark. For those of you guys who... Oh, nice lure. Oh, I'll talk about that in just a second. And you can see how good that tracking is. Hit him with it, Jordan. Hit him with it.
With what?
I thought you were going to clontality him.
Oh, no.
Well, we've got about 10 seconds left at the 30-second mark. For those of you who have seen the movie, the Terenzi brothers, the pair of brothers who drive the ice cream truck, crashed through a random wall on the outskirts of the map, notifying all humans and clowns where
it
is. And luckily, all of us clowns are right next to us, so let's see if we can stop them.
Prepare for battle.
Yes, sir. Get that finger lure ready. Don't let them walk through, dude.
I've got my
behind
cocoon
you.
Ready.
Right here.
I can't hit that.
No! Oh, my.
Okay, well, that was unsuccessful.
There's one more left. I think they might die to the clown apocalypse here.
Okay, here it goes. Yep, here comes somebody right now.
Ooh.
Oh, I downed them, so they'll just double hit them. Nice. Okay. Well, yeah, so that's the final. What happens with the clown apocalypse, it spawns in at 0 seconds, the middle of the map it spawns, and then it gradually expands outwards. So you have about, it's like 6 to 10 seconds. It just depends on where, because the Trenzy brothers already, I'll go to the clown side. once again. Some of that information on the stat stuff is not accurate, but you can still see that we have a lot out. Clowns are obviously a lot more in depth with their gameplay customization because you're not scavenging the map. You're already prepared. So you can kind of thumb through the different types of clown types here, which kind of highlight the different tank and, you know, all the different types of clowns that you know and love are in these different categories. Then you can obviously go through the ray gun selection as well as the secondary. You've got your tricks, which will be coming up next. I think Albert dove into that.
Yeah.
Tricks, you can see your two standards, the clown jump and the lull, and then your third customized ones. Customize where your clown talities, which clown talities you have. So that, like, you can, I don't know if you called this out, but you have a clown tality wheel in game, so you can select which clown tality to execute before you actually go and interact with the human on the ground.
Yeah, so you can switch up your clown tality mid game and give yourself some variety.
Yep. Once again, emote wheel. And then last, but the best of all, is the clown customization cosmetically, which definitely falls in the different categories of which clowns you have specifically. So when you're jumping in, like, you start out with the standards of Jumbo and Spiky and Shorty and stuff, but then you're able to kind of dive in and customize a lot of those elements, whether that's the collar, the jumpsuit, the shoes, the makeup, the hair. A lot of different options, and the combinations get pretty wild, so it's...